Hi nerds, hi yogis. Carly and Rose here, and welcome to a Nerdy Yogi YouTube channel and a Nerdy Yogi studio. Today we are going to start a little series that I'm going to call Bombshell Blasts, inspired by DC Bombshells, which are very cool. If you haven't Googled them yet, definitely do so. Take a look. They're going to be called Bombshell Blasts because we're going to be doing a yoga shred inspired workout. So it's a HIIT style workout. HIIT being high intensity interval training. Basically, that is a type of workout where you're expending a lot of energy in a very quick amount of time. And what it does is it helps boost cardio, it has strength training elements to it, it's going to get into your fast twitch muscles, and it will help you burn calories for a couple of days after you've actually done the practice. Now, we'll just be doing one HIIT move per sequence, make it easy, kind of introduce you to this type of workout. Yoga HIIT, of course, is great because it's yoga-inspired anatomy, so it is safer for your joints, which is definitely what we want, especially if we're doing a HIIT type of practice. We want to make sure that we have good alignment and we're being good to our body. That being said, our first practice today is going to be, actually one not on the poster, we'll be doing Batwoman over here. Since she's by her lonesome figure, we'll start with her. And so kind of we're going to work like this. We'll do a quick warm-up, do the yoga HIIT move, quick cool down, and then I'll do one for each of the bombshells for fun, you know, why not? And I have a Tabata timer ready to go. The way that HIIT works, or the yoga shred inspired flow is gonna work, is it's 20 seconds on, 10 seconds of rest, 20 seconds on, 10 seconds of rest for 4 minute round total. So the Tabata timer, because it's called Tabata timing, that sequence is gonna be very helpful for us to know how long we're exercising for. So to start, I'm sitting on my knees here in a comfortable position. We'll start with some cat-cow. So inhale here, exhale, inhale, exhale. Last one here, inhale, exhale. Now we'll open the arms behind you, inhale, and exhale. Just rounding, stretch your arms. Come to a circular move in front of you, inhale here. Exhale, inhale, last time exhale, and this time inhale up, and exhale, stretch wide, back and open, inhale up, exhale, nice big stretch, and last time inhale here, exhale, this time interlace your fingers behind you, get a wave of the spine, stretch the arms long. Open up the chest and exhale. Very nice. We'll come to our hands and knees here. And I want you to start by just grounding into the earth a little bit, lifting up onto your knees, and start to pedal your feet in this very bent low movement. Getting our legs warmed up, prepared for the HIIT or yoga shred move that we'll do today. And then you can bring it into more of a down dog, continuing to that pedaling your feet motion. Warming up the legs, the calf muscles. Awesome. Making your way back down. We'll come to sit on our feet again. This time tuck your toes under for just a moment while I talk you through what we're gonna do. Our Batwoman pose, if you will, is going to be kind of a running plank pose. So we want to make sure we have really good alignment, of course, like I said earlier. So really ground into the earth with your fingertips, then come up to rest on the palms. Most of your weight's going to be on the ring of the palms, very light here on the heel. And this is going to be a bit more cardio intensive, but we do want to make sure we have good alignment. Don't wing out your elbows. Keep them in, keep them tucked. Once you ground into the earth, wave up and then use that press to lift your knees. Now you can stay on your knees if you want to just do the move like this. That's no problem. You work your way up, obviously, and just continue to play where you are in the spectrum. But we'll start here at a low position and just gently bringing the knees into the chest, or towards the chest rather. And we'll just do that, like I said, for the full Tabata round. And as we go, we can continue to add levels to make it more difficult. You can run faster, slower. Find your own pace. You'll probably get a little out of breath. I'm probably going to get a little out of breath and it's totally fine. That's why we do these practices. So we'll hit start here on the handy little timer. It will beep to prepare us, and then we'll work. It will beep to, there it goes, ground into the earth. Come into your bent knee plank and a light run. And just bringing your knees towards your chest. Again, finding a good pace for you that's challenging, but one that you can maintain. Awesome. Sit here. You can have your toes tucked or untucked. We'll rest for 10 seconds. Interlace your fingers behind your chest and stretch. And back into it. Awesome. Now, I need to make sure I can still be able to talk to you, obviously, and give cues and everything like that, but you want to be going just fast enough that you, not like super out of breath, but that you couldn't necessarily carry on a conversation. Because we want to make sure that you're getting the most out of your workout. That's why you come to the mat, obviously. Take a break here. Grounding into the earth, back into plank, or a bent knee plank. Making sure, again, to not wing out your elbows. Making sure that that lift is coming from the earth and strong core. Awesome. And if you ever need to sit out around, feel free to absolutely do so. Again, this is your practice. You do what is going to be best for you. Making sure to breathe. Seems silly to have to remind you, but definitely got to make sure you're breathing. And if you need to breathe through your mouth, you can do that as well, whatever gets you more oxygen. You can hear too, if you're starting to feel it on the wrists, massage out your forearms and wrists. And if you want to take it up a notch, you can come into more of a downward dog. But we do want to start with our knees being bent, again, for good, safe alignment. Awesome. Feel free to do lion's breath here as you need. That nice big sigh helps empty out any oxygen you might not have exhaled and leaves a lot of room for you to inhale new oxygen, which you definitely need right now. Shake it out. Lion's breath. And back into your pose. And if you need to, just think about, you know, Batwoman. You always see statues and pictures of her with the bat. She's running around the bases, you know? Get inspired by that, I guess. Alright, remember to take rests as you need them, but we are almost done. Remembering to engage your core and really pressing into the earth and away from the earth, using that to move your knees. And we're done. Yay. All right, so shake out your wrists. Massage your forearms. You can grab onto your wrists and get some traction, pulling away your wrist away from your forearm. Now from here, you wave from side to side, stretching your shoulders open behind you. Do some cat-cow. gently moving until your heart rate slows down. You don't want to just get your heart rate up and then stop. It won't feel very good. So, slow, gentle movements. Move your arms like we did at the beginning to warm up. Whatever movement you need to bring your heart rate down to a more calm resting position, and then come to sit here, windshield wiper your legs. Obviously, we worked those a bit with our running Batwoman pose. And stretch out your feet in front of you. Start with bent knees, fingertips behind you. Wave up and get a long spine, and then wave yourself to a more forward fold. And from here, if you're not bending the spine in any weird way, then you can extend your legs just to that first moment of stretch. Inhale here. Exhale, maybe waving a little deeper. You can even grab onto your toes if that feels good to you. And just keep rocking yourself back and forth. And then from here, making your way back to the earth, come to a lying down position, hug your knees into your chest, circle them one way and then the other. And yogi's choice moment, feel free to do any remaining stretches that you need. I like to hold my feet here in a goddess pose with my knees wide and rock back and forth. But take any last stretch or pose that you might need, and then extend your legs out long, coming into your Shavasana resting pose. Stay here, just breathing, catching your breath if you haven't done that yet, and stay in this pose for a couple of minutes before going into the rest of your day. Be sure to like, share, subscribe, all that good stuff. Make sure that you get all of the next bombshell blasts that we're going to have coming out. And of course, get on the VIP email list. You'll get some exclusive content. Namaste.